bound by blood. That's what the old archives tell about the living fortresses and their pilots. The machines created to protect the kingdom of Arcadia became its worst nightmare. After Mesmeroth shred the world to pieces, corrupted living fortresses made sure nothing would rise from the ashes. People survived. The men with my bloodline. The living fortress Oceanhorn can trace my blood. I am a descendant of that ancient pilot who used to operate Oceanhorn. Somewhere there, beyond those impenetrable walls of White City, rests Oceanhorn. Thousands of bones of ancient Arcadians. The kingdom cannot be rebuilt until that monster is destroyed.
Kid, you came! My plan did not work out. All of a sudden it changed and I could not control it anymore. But I was able to cut it loose from the power grid. It cannot repair itself now. Listen, when Oceanhorn wakes up, it will try to fry you with its death ray. Make sure you are prepared. You are a tough kid. You have your mother's strength. Light inside you that makes you go one step further. Something I never had. When this is all over, we should visit her grave and tell her all about your adventures. No, it's moving again. Run, kid! Just leave me and save yourself!
Thank you. It's no use! Nobody else should be able to control it. No!
Thank you.
I begin to understand. When Mesmeroth cursed the sacred emeralds, the balance of the world was disturbed and it had a severe effect on living fortresses. Without the guidance of the emblems, they lost their sense of purpose. When your mother brought the emblem of Sun back to this world, some part of Oceanhorn woke up. Suddenly, it had a direction. It desperately started to seek the right pilot, a descendant of the Knight's bloodline. Only the most noble among knights were chosen to be pilots of living fortresses. Those were our ancestors who operated these war machines. All that Arcadians ever wanted was to secure peace, but sometimes desperately clinging onto doing good can be an act of evil. It was forbidden to combine technology, magic, and blood in Arcadia. But Archimedes was willing to cross that border by creating living fortresses when the existence of Arcadia was threatened. He was not the first one to succeed in these dark arts. Mesmeroth turned himself immortal by doing the same thing. He sacrificed his body by casting a dark magic that bound his soul into a machine. Well, it's all over now. The sins of our ancestors have been purified and the power of the emblems have been restored. It's time to rebuild the world, kid.